Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to learn about how we can send tables in our emails with the help of Google Apps Script. I have a situation like this. We have two columns here and I have something in these two columns and I want to send these two columns as a table, right? In my previous videos, I have taught you how you can send text line items in the email with the help of Apps Script, but in this case, we are going to send the table as it is. So if I go and run this script and if I go and check my inbox, I'll receive an email and this is my email, right? Hi team, please follow the list and here is the list. I want to create a dynamic option in this. For example, if this list decreases, or you can say increases to here, and if I go and run the script, it should accommodate every data in the table and it should send an email. Here it is. So that means we can send tables in emails with the help of Google Apps Script with a well formatted template. So we are going to learn how we can do that. So for that, I'm going to extension section here. I'll click on extension and here is the code, right? So I'm going to walk you through the code so that it will save your time instead of live coding, right? So in this code.js, I have created two functions. One function is this send mail, okay? And the second function is this get data, right? So this is our main function, which is basically sending email with the help of mailapp.emailsend, in which I have mentioned two, subject and HTML body. And in the HTML body, I'm calling get data function, which is this function, right? So that means this function is creating a template in HTML and passing it to this object. And once it is passed, this mail app is sending that particular table in HTML format to the Gmail, right? So our main code, which is basically bringing the data and making a HTML template, is this. So let's deep dive into this. I've written function get data here, start of the code. Now these three lines, ss equals to spreadsheet, I have dot open URL. This is a URL of this sheet. You can just copy paste your Google Sheet URL as it is. Then we have the tab name ss.get sheet by name and sheet 1. Sheet 1 means this sheet, right? So you have to put your sheet or tab name in these double quotes. Once it is done, I am saving everything in this particular sheet in this variable. Data values equals to tab.getDataRange.getValues. Just remember, anything written in this particular tab, whether it is here, here or here, it will consider it as a table and it will start preparing a HTML template. Just try to make sure that there are no empty rows or columns before the table starts and just keep it as it is. If I go back, now with the help of these three lines, we have pulled our data and saved it in data values variable in a 2D format, right? So after that, I'm going to create a variable HTML in which basically you can say it is a start of the HTML. So to explain this, I'll just open a HTML with the help of this plus sign. I'll just open this HTML. Okay. So basically whenever you create a HTML body, right, you have to keep in mind that there are tags to be followed when you are creating HTML template. Similarly, in this case, you can see we have started HTML, we have closed an HTML, then we have head, we have body, and in the body, we create our HTML content, right? I'll just delete this. In the same fashion, in the HTML variable, I started writing my email. Hi team, please follow the list. And then I entered less than br greater than, and then less than br greater than. This means a new line break. After printing this particular statement, there will be two lines of gap, okay? And then I'm concatenating this particular HTML variable with a table. So this is the start of the table. So in upcoming lines, we are going to populate our table with the help of values present in the data values variable, right? So this is the start of the table. You can just forget this thing about it. And we are going to just focus on this part, only this part, right? Okay. So before starting, I want to know whether this sheet is empty or not. If it is empty, then no need to print anything. Give a pop-up that there is no data in this. But if there is data present in this sheet, then check the length of the data. Length means the number of rows. If it is greater than 0, so for example, in this case, it is 21 rows, right? So it is greater than 0. That means it is true. It will enter in this particular part. And then we are using two for loops, this and this, right? And both the for loops, we have different variable I and j. I variable is basically counting the number of rows in which row we are currently in. Whenever the script runs, it will check for which row we are talking about. So for example, if I say this is a 0th row, that means this is the first row we are talking about. So in that first row, what are the cell values? That means A1 and then B1. So A1, B1 is taken care with the help of second for loop, and the first row is taken care of with the help of first variable I, right? So in this case, I entered the first row because this is true. I equals to 0, I less than data values dot length, right? So this is true. It will enter in the second row. Before pulling out the data from the cells, right? We have to create a table row. That's why we have done HTML equals to HTML plus this particular section. It will add everything. It will add a template in this HTML variable. So in this case, it will create a table row. And after creating a table row, we will start pulling up the cells in that particular row. So for that, we are using second for loop, in which we are checking whether j equals to 0, and if it is less than data values I dot length. Data values I means, data value 0 means the first row. Data value 0 is first row, and the length of that row, that length means there are two columns, right? Students are marks. That means it will run for two iterations. So this particular for loop will run for two iterations, and it will pick students as a text and then marks as a text, and it will save in the template, right? So in this case, once we get the data, right, before adding up in the HTML, we have to check whether this particular row number, in this case it is 0, in this case it is 0. If it is 0, that means this is the first row, that means this is the header. And usually in the table, we usually try to format things up so that it looks nice if it is the header. You can change the font size, right? So for example, if it is 0, then do this. If it is not 0, then in that case, do this. And what exactly we are doing here is, we are just using utilities.format string, and we are adding up the formatting what we want to this text, which is present in data values I, j. And until we reach a total number of rows present in the data. So it will go for 0, then 1, then 2. And for all these three iterations, it will check twice for each an element in the row, and will bring it up and save it in a template. Once this particular section is done, everything will get saved into HTML, and we have just closed the table tag here. And after closing table tag, so I'll just write down return HTML. So when send email function will run, it will call get data. As soon as get data starts, it will return HTML template with the help of this statement. And once it is returned here, this mail app.send email knows how to handle HTML body, because we have used HTML body attribute here, and it will read the body and it will send it as it is. And that you can see in here, if I go and delete this, And if I go and add something like age 20, and if I try to run this, it will give me three columns and it will automatically adjust everything. Here it is. So this is how we can send data in tabular format with the help of Google Apps Script. This is how we can send data in a table format in Gmail with the help of Google Apps Script. I hope you liked my video. Thanks for watching.